Hi students, welcome back to the class. In this video, we will learn about a poem from the textbook Beehive. So the name of the poem is Wind. At the starting of this video, I will be giving a summary. After learning the summary, you copy the summary in your fair notebook and watch the video. In the video, I will be giving the explanation of all the stanzas in the poem, and also in the end of the video, I will be giving the message from the poem. So we have a good message in this poem called The Wind. So let's start the class.
The poem Wind is written by Subramanya Bharati.
And this is the summary that you have to copy. The poem Wind by Subramanya Bharati is originally in Tamil. It was translated in English by A.K. Ramanujan. The poem describes the power of the wind on nature and human life. It focuses on the violent aspect of the wind that causes heavy destruction. The poet tells us that the wind makes fun of the weak people and things, but favors the strong. He therefore suggests the reader be strong, both physically and mentally. The wind here is a symbol of hardship and obstacles which human beings have to face in their life. If we remain strong, we can overcome any obstacles. Dear students, now let's see the explanation of the poem Wind. It is a beautiful poem in which the poet is talking to the wind and is highlighting its destructive power. He has linked the destructive power of the wind to the adversities of life and says that weak people break down, but stronger people emerge out of adversities stronger. In the first stanza, the poet requests the wind to come softly and not to break the window shutters and not to scatter the papers. She also requests the wind not to throw down books from the shelf. The poet complains to the wind that in spite of his request, it blew strongly and threw the books off the shelf, tore their papers and brought the rain. In the second stanza, the poet says the wind makes fun of the weaklings and crushes the crumbling houses, crumbling doors, crumbling rafters, crumbling wood, crumbling bodies, crumbling lives and crumbling hearts. Here, the word crumbling is repeated many times to emphasize a viewpoint that everything that is weak crumbles in the face of a strong wind. The powerful god of wind winnows human beings. He sifts all the people, and those who are weak fall down and get crushed. Here, a comparison is made between wheat and people. Just like we winnow the wheat to separate the grain from chaff, the wind god separates the strong people from the weak. The last stanza, the poet suggests that the wind will not obey us. The poet wants us to make friendship with the wind. Therefore, to accept the adversities in life, he says that the problems will keep coming in, so we should be prepared to face them. We should build strong homes and close the doors of our house firmly so that the wind cannot get in. And then he says that we should also make our bodies strong and hearts firm to face the challenges in life. Once we are strong enough, we can overcome all the adversities. If we become strong, the wind will befriend us. The wind supports the strong fires but extinguishes weak fires. The friendship of wind is good, and we should praise the god of wind every day. The poem gives an important message that we should make ourselves mentally tough and physically strong in order to survive the hardship of life. A weak person crumbles down like a weak building. We must make these destructive forces our friends with our strength and determination. And then we will be happy that we had these challenges in our life, because they help us become stronger and better.